friends. It's Nancy and it's Saturday. So this is just a free-for-all. I'm still working on this abandoned house journal, having a riot. I want to use some of this vintage feed sack fabric to make a pocket. But I'm going to use a couple of embroidery stitches. So in order to stick this fabric, I'm just using a little bit of glue. Then I don't have to be so fussy. I'm just trying to match up the edges. Okay. Done. What kind of thread will I use? Something This is some kind of wool. That'll do nicely. So it's still Friday here, but I'm not posting this video till tomorrow. There we go. Just putting a knot in my thread. Okay, so another thing I think I want to do is, these were pieces from a Dresden plate. Wow. So I'm going to cut off the rounded edge. Might have to trim that with my scissors. Cut my finger off. Did you see that? Yeah, glass might not be the best surface for cutting with a rotary cutter. Oh, you know what I got? I have two. Maybe not. Thought I had two. This is a little clothing tag that was in a vintage girl's dress. If I just going to tear this apart. Do I want to do it like this? I think I do. Yes. Yes, yes. I really am enjoying this whole process. I've been watching the third season of All Creatures Great and Small. Not the old BBC version, but the most recent one that was on PBS. I think it was earlier this winter, but I didn't get around to watching it. Until this week. And it's just so beautiful. And the stories are so charming. And my favorite is the character who plays Tristan. I liked him in it's a series about this family living in Corfu. I don't remember. Oh, something about Corfu, anyway. He was good in that too. Nothing too challenging about this. I'm just doing some visible stitches, and the thread I'm using is a wool. Again, one of those things that I found in somebody's old sewing box that was probably came with the purchase of a new sweater. And I can't just keep collecting these things, gotta use them. And maybe nobody will ever notice that this was vintage wool from some old lady's sewing box. But I know. No big plans for the weekend. After all, I can't be seen in public with with my black eye. I will be quite the spectacle. I imagine it's going to get a lot worse looking than it gets better looking, so I can just pretend we're in COVID lockdown. turn this edge a bit. Thinking I might like to add a little piece of something, a little crochet bit, maybe. Except I can't see anything. Probably also want a button. No, too new looking. Thick. Let's see. This one. This is a bone one, actually. And of course, I always have to look once more. Ooh, that one's fun. I'll go with the bone one. Okay. I'm just going to tie a knot here. I had this doubled for the first stitches. I've just cut this past the knot, and now it's going to be one strand. do have a couple of errands to run. Got medications to pick up. Oh, and I need to pick up something I purchased at an online auction last week. I should have picked it up last week and I didn't, because I had a whole bunch of things I was looking at for this week, and usually they'll just hold something from one week to the next if I don't pick it up. But I didn't get in on anything this week. Everything went really expensive. I want to use something bright. Just sew that button down. I was thinking maybe red. Oh, here's another piece of wool. Maybe when Doug gets home from work, we can go for a car ride and take care of those chores. Get a coffee. One end is much longer than the other, and instead of trying to fix it, I'm cutting it off. So there. Got supper figured out. It's already half done, actually. I'm doing a Mexican chicken and rice. Oh. Well, that's no good. I don't think it'll fall off. We also have to catch up on this week's episode of Ted Lasso. So maybe it'll just be a pseudo date night. Go for a drive, come home, have some dinner, then watch TV together. That's about as exciting as I get. Okay, where would we like to put this little thing? Definitely the other one. Okay, let me just see how square this is not. Maybe I better stick with the art glitter. Yeah, things don't get much more exciting here. You know. The odd brush with death when I throw myself on the ground. That's about it. Some dark gray something. I think I'll stitch that down with this. A lot of stitching happening in this journal. Did anybody see where I put my needle? Probably looking right at it, aren't I? Okay, I found it. Come on, you. There we go. Need a knot. It's definitely going to be the hunt and peck variety. Wacky. I think I'll pause so that you don't have to watch this painful. It's painful. Process. Okay, I've got that all stitched in. I grabbed these pieces of yarn. Donna said she liked to pin, maybe I'll pin it on the back, some embroidery threads to the fabric pages. This must have been from some little embroidery kit or something. Oh, it's got brown and blue. Okay, we can use that. Also, I did get the signature sewn together. Let me just show you. So I did a 5-hole pamphlet stitch, and I tied the knot on the outside. All right, back to the pile of stuff. I was saying I needed to make a tag that will go in here to make this stiff. I do like that. So this is due dates of premiums. Okay. cut it too short. Well. That's the way the cookie crumbles, I guess. See what else I can add across that top. I could cut it off. This window thing is kind of cool. I think I'll leave this for something else. Why are you? You are 4¾. So if I make this one just over insurance policies, I should be able to get another bobbin out of this. So I'll put that there. this button card. I do want to put it somewhere. I had a brad, or not a brad, but a eyelet somewhere. I think it was blue. What did I do with it? I don't even know. Let's get another one. I do not like it. Let's do something else. That's better. Just about. I got this in Savannah at that art store, Starlandia. If only I had discovered it years ago. Okay. Maybe a little bit of ribbon. Like that. I like the looks of that. This was a handle from a paper gift bag. I think I'm going to add that to a page edge somewhere. Okay. Maybe a different page. Okay. I'm just going to put glue down the edge. So it can be used as a tuck spot. Alrighty. Huh. Where was this one? Cut these little doodads off the end. So this is what I would call twill tape. Okay. What's this stuff? Perle cotton. Looks challenging. I don't want to be challenged. What's this? This doesn't look challenging. This looks lovely. Having a hard time with this. Oh. Got a knot in it here. So this is ordinary thread or embroidery floss. Cotton floss, six strand floss thread. Wow. Okay. I'm gonna put my mouse pad here. And got my piercing ruler here. And pokebook. I'm gonna go every half inch, I guess. No, quarter inch. This one. Nope. Messed something up. Turn it around. That thread stuck to my finger. Must have been gluey. Just about done. Now, The next thing I want to do just trim that a little shorter. I don't care if it frays. I think that's the name of the game. Fray away. Okay. Now I want another one of my pins. So I've got another rusty pin here. Girl. Got some short and some long here. It's about time for a cup of tea, I think. Okay. So what I want to do is stitch this pin to this edge. And then I'm going to add like a piece of fabric or something, maybe a piece of lace there. So didn't like my knot. Pin. So I want to make sure it's the stationary part that I want to. So, once I got this sewn in, I think I'm going to go take some Tylenol and have myself a little rest. So I'll do something interesting with that. Am I getting too many pockets in here? I could be. For sure, I could be. Nope. Oh well, I'll look at that later. It's time for a rest. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you thought this was interesting, and I really am enjoying doing this project. There is a tutorial on past and pages. Oh, there's my texture paste. I was looking for you. Huh. So absolutely, I would recommend it if you wanted to create something similar. I'm having a good time, really. So thanks so much for joining me. We will talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.